Hi everyone, Steve Patterson here from Photoshop Essentials. In this video, I'll show you the difference between opening an image and placing an image in Photoshop. Both the open command and the place command let you select an image and open it. But where that image ends up once it's in Photoshop depends on which command you use. One will open the image in its own separate document, while the other lets you open it as a layer in an existing document, which makes it easy to blend two images together. Let's see how they work. I'm using Photoshop 2021, but you can follow along with any recent version. If you like these videos, be sure to subscribe and let's get started. Let's start with the Open command, which you can get to by going up to the File menu and choosing Open. But before I select it, if we look further down the list, there's another command called Place Embedded. And this is what we use to place an image into Photoshop. At the moment, the Place Embedded command is grayed out, which means we can't select it. And the reason is that I currently have no other documents open. Before we can place an image, we need to have at least one document already open. And you'll see why in a moment. So since we can't select Place Embedded, I'll choose the Open command. Then I'll navigate to the folder that holds my images. In this case, I have two JPEG images, a portrait image and a texture. Both were downloaded from Adobe Stock. I'll click on the portrait image to select it, and then I'll click Open. And the image opens in Photoshop as expected. Now, what has actually happened is that Photoshop created a new document to hold the image and it placed the image inside it. We can see the name of the document in the tab just below the options bar. I need my second image as well, the texture, so I'll open it by going back to the File menu. But this time, since I already have one document open, the Place Embedded command is no longer grayed out, which means I could select it. But to see the difference between Open and Place Embedded, I'll ignore it for now and I'll once again choose the Open command. Then I'll select my texture image and I'll click Open. But notice that the second image opened in a separate document, and I now have two documents, one for each image. We can switch between the documents by clicking the tabs, but the images are completely separate from each other. Each document has its own layers panel showing the image on the background layer, but because the images are in separate documents, there's no way for them to interact. Now, that's fine when we're working on each image independently and we don't need them to interact. In that case, the Open command works great because you would want the images to open in separate documents. But what if we want to blend or combine the two images together? In that case, having them in separate documents doesn't work. We need a way to open both images into the same document. And that is where the Place Embedded command comes in. I'll close my texture image by clicking the small X in its tab. But remember that to place an image into Photoshop, we need to have at least one document already open. So I'll leave my portrait image open. Then to place the texture image into this document, I'll go up to the File menu, but instead of choosing the Open command, I'll choose Place Embedded. I'll select the texture image, and then I'll click Place. And this time, instead of opening in a separate document, it opens in the same document as the first image. By default, Photoshop opens the free transform command so we can resize the image before placing it. Since my texture is a bit smaller than the portrait, I'll drag the handles to make it larger. Then to accept it and close free transform, I'll click the check mark in the options bar. In the layers panel, notice that Photoshop placed the texture on its own layer above the portrait image. If I turn the texture off by clicking its visibility icon, the portrait reappears. And if I turn the layer back on, the texture reappears. So by using the Place Embedded command instead of the Open command, I was able to open both images into the same document. And because they're both in the same document, I can blend the two images together. With the texture layer selected, I'll change the blend mode to soft light. And this blends the texture into the image below it. Then to fade the texture so it's not so intense, I'll lower the opacity of the texture layer from 100% down to 60%. And there we have it. That's the difference between using the open command and the place embedded command in Photoshop. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you found it helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Visit my website, PhotoshopEssentials.com, where you'll find hundreds of Photoshop tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.